Tables in the school cafeteria. Cliques have gone wild in an unprecedented response to Troy Bolton's callback for the school musical. One skater dude was even seen mixing with the school band string section. Oh, the humanity!
This is much better, right?
Much better. So this is your private hideout?
Well, sort of. They usually keep this hallway locked during lunch, but sometimes one of the janitors will let me in and find some peace and quiet.
Wow. Seems to me like everyone on campus wants to be your friend.
Yeah. Unless we lose.
Oh. Must be tricky being the coach's son.
He's gonna freak when he hears about that singing thing.
You're worried?
It's just my parents' friends. They're always saying, "Your son, he's the basketball guy. He must be so proud." But you know, sometimes I don't want to be just the basketball guy. Sometimes I just want to be, you know, me.
I saw how you treated Kelsey at the audition yesterday. Do your friends know that part of you?
Are you kidding? To them, I'm just a playmaker, dude.
Then they don't know enough about you, Troy. Playmaker. That's such an odd phrase.
Oh, yeah? Well, about Pythagorean theorem. Now, that's pretty whack.
I think you mean Pythagorean.
Right. Totally whack, though.
At my other schools, I was the freaky math girl. That's all they thought I was. Always pointing at me and whispering behind my back. They made me feel like I was a freak, and I hated it. That's why I just want to keep a low profile here, so I can be me.
But you can't let people stop you from doing what you want to do. I mean, you are what you do, right? Kinda?
Well, that's easy for you to say. You're the big basketball star. You love the spotlight. I'm much happier curling up with a good book.
Hiding?
No.
Maybe?
Maybe. I don't know. Remember in kindergarten, you'd meet a kid, know nothing about them, and then 10 seconds later you were playing like you were best friends because you didn't have to be anything but yourself?
Yeah.
Well, singing with you felt like that. Like, safe, you know?
I never thought about singing, that's for sure. But when I look at you, I don't know, it's like anything's possible, you know?
So you really want to do the callbacks?
Oh, gee, I don't know.
Oh, that's okay. I mean, I guess I don't really want to either.
No. I'm in.
Really? Really?
Hey, just call me the freaky callback boy.
You're a cool guy, Troy, but not for the reasons your friends think.
You never know what you're gonna feel. You never see it coming, suddenly it's real.
Oh, it never even crossed my mind that I could ever, ever hope to find someone like you.
Oh, things change when you don't expect them to.
Everything I never knew that I've been looking for. showing me your top secret hiding place, Troy. Just like kindergarten.
Are you best friend?
No, it didn't go with my outfit.
That's funny. Hey, I was thinking maybe you'd like to come watch me play ball sometime.
I'd rather suck the mucus from a dog's nostrils till his skull caves in.
That doesn't sound very appetizing. Wouldn't you rather prefer a nice creme brulee or tiramisu? Ah, why did I say tiramisu? Ah.
Do you really think that's going to work?
It's the only way to save Troy and Gabriella from themselves.
So what you're saying is the individual must be sacrificed for the good of the whole. That's so very Karl Marx. Works for me.
Good. We'll get Troy in the locker room, and you nab Gabriella in the lab at exactly 1300 hours.
Whatever. Just work him until he caves. I mean, I know you really
look. Troy Bolton is my best friend. I know how to push all his little buttons. And remember, the line of communication is crucial to the successful deployment of this covert operation.
Chad, I didn't know you could say so many syllables together in one sentence. I'm really impressed.
Thanks. Been working on it all night. Now my watch says 1600 hours Mountain Standard Time. Are we synchronized?
Save it for Charlie's Angels, Chad. Au revoir, mon ami.
Ooh. I love it when you speak German.
Dankeschön.
All right, guys. 1, 2, 3, break!
Something isn't right. The jocks and the brainiacs mingling in study hall?
The jocks already were most of the school, but if they get Troy in the music role, well then they've conquered the entire student body.
And if the brainiacs get Gabriella hooked up with Troy, the science club goes from drool to cool, and Troy will be hers forever. Ryan, we need to save our show from people who don't know the difference between a Tony Award and Tony Soprano.
Yeah, but how?
Darvis, I have a plan.
Lucy?
I'll tell Darvis that Troy and his dad went to sabotage the auditions because she gave him detention.
Like she's gonna believe that.
Ryan. She'll believe anything I tell her. I'm the president of the drama club.
Yeah, and the president is not supposed to lie, Sharpay.
Yeah, and the vice president's supposed to smile, zip it, and do what I tell him to do. All right, let's go.
Where's your head at?
In the game, coach. In the game.
And where's In all my years of theater, I've never encountered such small-minded subterfuge.
Boys, practice is over. Hit the showers. Now!
All right, Bolton. Cards on the table. Now. Don't play dumb with me.
I'm not playing.
Some very reliable sources have told me about your little plot to humiliate me and the drama club, and I'm telling you, it ain't gonna fly.
What are you talking about, Darbus?
If you and your all-star son are planning some kind of practical joke in my Chapel of the Arts.
Troy doesn't even sing!
Well, then I guess you don't know your son as well as you think you do. But whatever the case, I will not allow Juliet and Romeo to be made into a farce.
Juliet and Romeo?
See? I knew it! If Troy is actually serious about auditioning, he's going to have to prove it. I will not allow you to make fools out of the drama club.
Hey, you don't need my help to do that.
And you, Mr. I'm soaring, I'm flying.
Nice to see you too, Miss Darbus.
I thought you were genuine, Troy. Wrong again, I guess.
What was that all about?
You wanna tell me something, Bolton? Something about singing?
No. Well, you know.
No, I don't know. Darbus the Deranged just chewed my head off because she thinks you're plotting something.
No. I was just helping someone audition. That's all. It was nothing.
You bet it's nothing. In case you've forgotten, the biggest game of your life is coming up on Friday. Get your head in the game, Bolton. Your team is depending on you.
I was going to stay and work on my free throws.
Since you were late for practice, again, that's the least you can do.
Hey.
So, this is your real stage.
Well, I guess you could call it that. Or just a smelly old gym. Whoa. Don't tell me you're good at hoops, too.
Oh, yeah. One time, I scored 41 points in the league championship game.
What? No way.
Mm-hmm. And in the same day, I invented the PlayStation and the iPod. I've been rehearsing with Kelsey.
I know. Me too. And, I was late for practice. So if I get kicked off the team, it'll be on your conscience.
Well, I wasn't
going to... Chill.
I'm sorry, miss! Practice is closed!
But practice is over.
Not until the last player leaves the gym, Bolton. Team rules.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir.
Dad, this is Gabriella Montez.
Your detention buddy?
Psst, Gabriella, Taylor needs you up in the lab right away. Fantastic.
I'll see you later, Troy. Nice to meet you, Coach Bolton.
Goodbye.
Detention was my fault, not hers.
You haven't missed practice in 3 years! That girl shows up, and you've been late twice!
That girl is named Gabriella. She's very nice.
Helping you miss practice isn't very nice. Not in my book or your team's.
She's not a problem. She's just a girl.
But you're not just a guy! You're the team leader. What you do affects not only this school, but the entire state! If you're not completely focused on Friday, we won't win. And if you don't, you'll regret it for the rest of your life.
You mean like you?
You're a playmaker, Bolton! Not a singer!
Did you ever think maybe I could be both? My name's Troy, Dad, not Bolton.
Thank you. not kidnapped Gabriella.
You can't escape!
There's a choice that you have to make.
It's pretty plain to see.
Either out or in,
you either lose or win.
Are you gonna turn your back on history?
On the night that you're a part of.
On the job that you were born to.
Legends won championships by worrying about some brainiac chick or auditioning for musicals?
Do you think these paradigms of education and accomplishment concern themselves with jocks or auditioning for musicals?
I don't think so!
Check out the champions who came before. They're the hero that you could be.
And put away that dream, cause there's no I in team. And the sacrifice is worth it, we all.
He always dreamed of it.
Heartbreak Bolton, another lost cause, bonehead, basketball's modest jock. But you, you're the future of civilization.
You're next in the line. You're part of the chain. And now that we can make it, don't break it.
You're the heir apparent. That's what everyone says. From Frida Kahlo, Indira.
I don't really care.
those stupid jazz squares.
Everybody loves a good jazz square. It's a classic. And why do we always have to do what you say?
Maybe because I know what I'm doing. Look, just do what I tell you, all right? I'm not taking any chances. That role is mine. I was born to play it.
Somebody in this room ought to chill out, sister. It ain't me. We'll get the parts we want. We always do.
I'm not talking about my role in the play, Ryan. I'm talking about my role in, like, the school. I'm not a jock. Definitely not a brainiac. But you know what? I'm the star. That's my role. And if they take that away from me, who am I?
Well, you could just be Sharpay. I mean, that's not so bad, is it?
Are you brain dead? No one's going to like me if I'm just Sharpay. But on stage, I can be anyone I want to be. I can be Juliet. I can be Annie Oakley. Not just dumb old Sharpay. I mean, come on, Ryan. They named me after a flabby dog.
All right, look, Sharpay. We've had the lead roles every year since, well, since birth. If we get them again, great. If not, we're still gonna be fabulous. Besides, could be worse. They could have named you Pug. Or Shih Tzu.
But Troy and that, oh, that thing.
Look, maybe Troy would like you more if you were just yourself for once.
Pardon me, Dr. Phil, but what exactly do you know? You're just a kid.
I'm only 8 minutes younger than you.
Yeah? Well, those are 8 pretty important minutes.
Oh, sorry. I didn't know you guys were in here.
Hi, Troy. Did you come to ask if I'd switch partners and audition with you? The answer is yes. Ryan, you're fired.
Sharpay!
No. But have you seen Gabriella? I've really got to talk to her.
Who?
Forget me.
Hey, last time I saw her, she's in the theater probably about 10 minutes ago.
Thanks, Ryan. You know, you're all right.
How can you stab me in the back like that? Helping the enemy?
I stabbed you in the back?
Well, at least you admit it. Now let's take it from the top. And lose those jazz squares.
Singing with you, so I said some things that I knew would shut them up. The guy you met on vacation is way more mean than the guy who said all those stupid things.
Troy, this whole singing thing's making the school crazy. You said it yourself. Everyone's treating you differently because of it.
Maybe that's because I don't want to be just the basketball guy anymore. Gabriella, when I look at you, I know I can be anyone I want to be. Because you look back at me without putting, like, all these limits on me, you know?
But your dad.
This isn't about my dad. This is about me. About how I feel. And I'm not letting the team down. They let me down. I'm going to sing. What about you?
I don't know, Troy.
It feels so right to be here with you. And now looking in your eyes, feeling my heart, the start of something.
living in my own world. Didn't understand that anything can happen when you take a chance.
I never believed in what I couldn't see. I never opened my heart to all the possibilities. Oh,
I know that something has changed.
Looks like we have a late-breaking Wildcat newsflash. The callbacks for Julie and Romeo have been moved up to tomorrow at 3 p.m. Sorry, Troy. This is Jack Scott. Over and out.
Singing is something you want to do. We should be boosting you up, not tearing you down.
It's hard to believe that I couldn't see. You're always there beside me. Good luck at the big game, Troy. Sorry about callbacks, Gabriella.
Sorry about the schedule. You guys are going to be great. I'm pretty sure Sharpay was dropped on her head as a baby. Anyways, I gotta run.
Listen up, guys. We've already made our decision.
Yeah, I'll be there for the team, Taylor.
Oh, no.
Me too, guys. It's just a musical anyway.
Just a musical? You know what he means. We can't be selfish. Not when our friends are depending on us, right, Troy?
Right.
But you can't!
But we can. Come on, Gabrielle. See you guys. We can't let them do this.
Yeah, a dream deferred and all that.
There's gotta be a way for them to do both.
Team huddle!
Hey, you spoke Jock.
I'm good with foreign languages, remember?
Good luck at the auditions, gentlemen.
Old crab mug. See?
Jack spelling. Oh, man.
Now.
Oh, Travis Club.
Fasten your seatbelts, kiddies. It's gonna be a bumpy ride.
The science decathlon is in the second floor lab, and the auditions for Julian Romeo are in the theater. And the league basketball championship game is in the gym. Wildcats rule, baby! And the game is just about to begin as the red-hot East High Wildcats take the court, led by team captain Troy Bolton.
Ladies and gentlemen, may the callbacks begin!
You have exactly 5 minutes to solve this equation. Ready, set, and...
Thank you.
competition, blow them all away.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Up, up, up to the top.
To the top, up, up,
to the top. Don't ever stop. Up, to the top.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Smoothie and turn around. Just the sweat of their direction.
Just a muscle.
Do the hustle.
We love hustle! Sing it for us! Sing it for us!
You have 30 seconds remaining to finish the equation.
Folks, there seems to be a problem with the lights. Till we fix it or pay the electrical bills, please make an orderly exit from the gym and head straight to the theater. Hurry up, please!
You want to sing, Troy?
It's now or never.
What are you talking about?
The lights! It was Taylor's idea.
You guys are the best!
I know, man! Not worry, let's go!
Just take a seat in the school's theater until we figure out exactly what's happening with the lights, and then we'll continue the match.
Gabriella! What are you still doing here?
Huh?
You don't have much time. My laptop can only hack the school's electrical grid for about 5 minutes. Troy's waiting for you on stage. Hurry!
You did this?
Buy me a Coke after you get the lead. Now run!
Sharpay lied to you so she could keep her spot in the musical.
Shut up.
Is he telling the truth? Did you abuse presidential privilege and knowingly lie to me?
I didn't lie.
I improvised a little.
We'll discuss this later, Miss Evans. But now get off my stage.
But I...
Get off my stage!
It's all yours, Miss Darvis.
Troy, Gabriella, you may begin your callback.
But we don't have a pianist.
Then we'll sing without music.
Oh, no, you won't. Pianist here, Miss Darvis.
You really don't want to do that.
Oh, yes, I really do. Ready on stage.
Now that's what I call charades.
I can't do it, Troy. It was so much easier when it was just you and me.
You pretend it is just you and me. Like kindergarten, remember? I'm right here.
Soaring, flying, there's not a star in heaven that we can reach.
If we're trying, so we're breaking free.
You know the world can see us in a way that's different from who we are.
Creating space between us till we're separate dogs.
Aren't you fair?
Be all that we can be.
This is it, folks. 5 seconds to go. East High has the ball, but it's down by one.
Five,
and the ball goes into Bolton.
Four, three,
he drives the lane.
Two, yeah.
get to it.